Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Maria Georgiadou and I'm a senior expert in renewable energy technologies in the European Commission, the Directorate General for Research and Innovation. I will present you the topic LC-SC3-RES-25-2020, entitled International Cooperation with Japan for Research and Innovation on Advanced Biofuels and Alternative Renewable Fuels. This topic is open under the Web Program 2020 of Secure, Clean and Efficient Energy under Horizon 2020, the current Research and Innovation Framework Program of the European Union. This topic is co-funded by the European Union and Japan. The topic aims to address the challenge on how to foster disruptive innovation for the complete replacement of fossil fuels in the transport and heat sectors by employing international cooperation for advanced biofuels and alternative renewable fuels and contributing to Mission Innovation Challenge 4 Sustainable Biofuels. Proposals submitted to this topic must involve Japanese organizations in the consortia who will collaborate with the European partners for the development of disruptive catalytic technologies in the areas of advanced biofuels and alternative renewable fuels. The aim is to develop novel catalysts and link lab-scale components and systems which improve the conversion efficiency and reduce the specific marginal cost of products like low-cost intermediate bioenergy carriers or advanced biofuels which are not based on food or feed, or alternative renewable fuels which are not of biological origin, excluding hydrogen. Proposals and underlying technologies must maximize the abatement of the greenhouse gas emissions and bring the technology readiness level up to 3. So the focus is on disruptive innovation and low TRL. The expected impact from this topic is to progress the scientific knowledge and the state of the art and strengthen the technology base of both the Japanese and the European counterparts while accelerating the development of renewable fuels that outperform the best fossil fuel alternatives, so that in the future we can completely replace the fossil fuels. More information about the call, which is open on the site of the European Union, can be found in the link included here. The conditions of the call are: the instrument is a research and innovation action. The call opened on 5th of May 2020 and is closing the 1st September 2020. The call budget is 5 million euros. The requirement is that at least one legal entity from Japan participates as beneficiary in the consortia per proposal. The indicative budget expected per proposal is from 2 to 5 million euros, meaning that between 2 to 3 proposals are expected to be funded from this topic. Japanese participants are expected to be funded by the corresponding funding Japanese authority, which is the Japan Science and Technology Agency, JST. More information on the call, which is announced in the JST site, can be found in the link provided here. And now I will answer some frequently asked questions related to this topic. Frequently asked questions. Question number one. What are examples of targeted catalytic technologies for biofuels and alternative renewable fuels? Answer. Chemical catalysis. Biochemical, electrochemical, thermochemical is expected in proposals rather than photocatalysis. The focus is on the disruptive nature of catalytic technologies and the low TRL. Question number two. What are examples of alternative renewable fuel technologies of types of fuels? Answer. Examples include electrochemical or chemical catalytic reduction of CO2 and or hybrids of chemical and electrochemical catalytic reduction of CO2, biochemical catalytic reduction with biocatalysts such as bacteria and microbes, etc. Alternative renewable fuels could be in the gasoline range, in the kerosene range, or even gaseous. Question number three. Should proposals cover both advanced biofuels and alternative renewable fuels? Answer. Addressing either advanced biofuels or alternative renewable fuels is sufficient. Question number four. How will be the application process with the Japanese partner? Answer. EU consortia, including Japanese participants, submit proposals to the EU call. In parallel, and while the EU call is open, the Japanese participants to EU proposals should apply for support, submitting their own proposal to the JST call. Question number 5. What measures will be taken if the COVID-19 situation extends into the recess period of the call, especially considering travel restrictions, difficulties in procurement, and similar? Answer. National authorities and international agreements determine mobility restrictions. In general, the European Commission may consider certain measures applying to force majeure regarding difficulties in the implementation of EU projects due to confinement restrictions that may be imposed in the future. Thank you very much for your attention.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Agata Przadka, and I'm a project manager at INEA, the Innovation and Networks Executive Agency. This is the agency that will implement the call topic, that will implement the projects that will be funded, and also we will go through the evaluation of your proposal. So I assume that you're very much interested to know how we will evaluate your proposal that will be submitted. I'll tell you that in a moment. Because before doing that, I want to remind you about the general eligibility and admissibility conditions. So according to the call topic, which is RES-25, I want you to remind that each proposal submitted must include at least one beneficiary, one legal entity established in Japan as beneficiary in the proposal. So this is very important to mind. Proposals which have not any beneficiary coming from Japan will not be evaluated because they will be non-eligible or non-admissible. There is also a page limit and there is also a specific layout you have to mind when submitting the proposals. And for all other conditions, you can check in the Annex B and C of the work program. And you find the links in this presentation here. We evaluate three criteria, which is excellence, which is impact, and the third one, which is implementation. The first one, excellence, we check what the proposal is actually about, what kind of research they want to do. And we'll check here, what are the objectives, what's the concept and methodology, so what do you want to do and how you want to do it. We check, or the experts check, what is the progress beyond the state of the art and the innovation potential of the proposal. And we also check additional points, which is like interdisciplinary approaches, how the stakeholder knowledge will be integrated into the proposal, and the gender dimension, if relevant. The second evaluation criteria is the impact. So we want you to have the impact as it is listed in the call text in the work program. So we won't check anything which is, or actually we will check what is beyond, for example, as the second bullet point, substantial impact not listed in the work program, but we want you to focus on the impact that is specifically written in the call text. Under the impact, the experts will check also the exploitation. So how do you want to use the results further to reach the next TRL levels? We want you also to explain us how do you do the communication and dissemination of the project results. And the final criteria to be checked will be implementation, and that means the work plan, including the resources, so you have to explain how do you plan to distribute the work, the management structures, including risk, innovation management. I think it's worth to mention that in your case, we also, of course, like for any other proposal, we will check complementarity of the participants in the consortium, including also how the Japanese participants are complementary to the rest of the consortium. And finally, we check also the task allocation. In terms of score, that's pretty simple. The maximum score for proposal is 15. And the minimum threshold that you have to get to be funded is 10. However, each criterion will receive a score. So if you have three criterions and the maximum score per criterion is 5, that's how we sum up it to 15, And important to know, it is that the minimum threshold for each criterion is at least 3. So you need to get at least 3, 3 and 4 to be funded. I have also a few links for you to read in case you would have any questions on the evaluation or on the eligibility admissibility criteria. These are very detailed. This is very detailed information you can find on our commission websites, and I invite you very much to check it before you submit to know what to expect. And that was all from my side, so thank you very much, and I hope that we'll have a lot of joint proposals, and good luck with application. Thank you.